difference. Works.
Yeah. Okay. Hi, welcome. We're here. Hi, welcome to One People, One World. I'm Rabbi Yaakov Cohen. I'm here with Chazen Leibel Basovsky. Chazen, how are you? Thank you for coming. Chazen, One People, One World. And he's a Chazen.
Yeah.
A Chazen means a cantor.
Yes.
And we're going to ask Chazen Leibel to perform for us, you know,
sure.
to sing a few songs, to tell us, you know, one of the things that Jewish song, prayer, is very, the words have a lot of meaning. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to ask Chazen to sing maybe about the rebuilding of the temple, which the temple stood in Jerusalem. We had two temples, and please God, we'll have the third temple today. And the temple serves as a light, a beacon of light to show, to give light to, as it says that the we're coming up to Hanukkah, and Hanukkah is the time when we celebrate the light in the temple. And an interesting thing about the temple windows that they were designed, they were wide on the outside and narrow on the inside, meaning that they were served as a means to normally windows are designed to bring light in. Over here, the windows were designed to let light go out and to shine up the world. And we would like to sing maybe Sheyibonei Beis HaMikdash, which means, please God, may we see the rebuilding of the temple. B'mheira b'yameinu means speedily in our time. Chazen Slavsky, please.
Yes, sure.
Please sing us a song.
Yerotzayin 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 Melefovonecho Melefovonecho Yehi Rotzayin Mifanecho Hashem Elokeinu Elokeinu Avoseinu Sheyibonei Beis HaMikdash V'meiraviyo
I want to just tell our viewers that we actually start the morning services. Every morning we sing that song. In Chabad, here on the Upper East Side, we sing, and we start the day realizing that the ultimate is to have the Beis HaMikdash, the Holy Temple in Jerusalem, to serve as a beacon of light for all people, as the Torah represents light for all people. And it's interesting that the Rebbe used to end the Farbrengen, used to signal, not, his name is Chazen Talashevsky, used to sing a little, he would sing this song.
That's right.
And you know, you come from a long line of Chazonim cantors.
Yes.
Tell us a bit about your grandfather, the Chazon, and your father, the Chazon. Gabbai, I think your father was a Gabbai.
Yes.
Was a Gabbai or Chazon? Both.
Well, he could have him, but it was mostly Gabbai.
Okay.
And he was a great man. Of course, he was not from today's stock. We know the old stock.
What's that with your grandfather? Your father's father.
My grandfather's father is a story about him. You could write a book about him.
Let's hear one story.
Yeah, well, he came from Russia, and he came as a boy. And when he came to America, he was going to go back to Russia because he couldn't get used to American style. He was from Russia. And as he was on the boat going back to Russia, he saw a lady, and the lady said right away, "There's my husband." Without just like that. And that's how he found his wife. And he didn't go back to Russia. He remained in America. And that's the story of my grandfather.
How did you come to Lubavitch?
Well, my grandfather was, he was raised in Brooklyn. And I heard so much about the Rebbe before this.
The previous Rebbe, Rabbi Joseph Isaac Schneerson.
That's right.
He came to America in 1940.
That's right. Yeah. So you heard about him, and somehow he just glued to him. You know, it's just like